Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about my process of cleaning up my Tesla Model Y and also my winter preparation. So here is basically the tools that I use for cleaning my Tesla Model Y. I use the two bucket method. I have a wash mitt, the wash guards for both, the grit guards for both buckets. For soap, I use Atom shampoo. I also have a pressure washer from Greenworks, 1600 PSI. This is where you want to be careful. You don't want to use a too strong of a pressure washer as you can chip off paint. Nothing to do with Tesla paint, by the way. It's just paint in general. When you have a really high PSI pressure washer, it will take the paint off as well. So pressure washer, and I also have a foam canyon. This is a Trinova foam canyon. It's a fancy one, but you don't really need it. Any foam canyon will work. I just liked it, but you know, you can use whatever you want. And then I have a couple other things, so some glass cleaner. Recently I also bought some 303 glass kind of graphene coating or ceramic coating for glass. Basically it gives it a slickness to glass so that the water wouldn't stick. Mainly this is for winter prep. I also have a Meguiar ceramic wax, same reasoning. It's an extra more durable wax. And compared to traditional wax, this will last 2 to 3 months. It also has SiO2, which is a chemical compound that you put into your car's paint, which will give it the hydrophobicness on your car paint, so things won't stick to your paint as long, and water will basically drop off like how ceramic coating would for your car, but lasts only about 2 to 3 months. So there's that. I'll talk about the process of how to apply it later. And from there, a couple other things as well. I have 303 aerospace. This is for all my black trims. As you guys know, it's chrome deleted on a Tesla Model Y, but there's also a lot of plastic trims in the front, the two side skirts, and the back diffusers. They're all plastic, and you want to protect them with some 303 so they don't crack and gray out. As many YouTubers online who review the Teslas have talked about, these plastic trims gray out over time. So just to get started, when you buy a car and you do your first detail clean, use some 303, put it all over your plastic trim, and then reapply every 2 to 3 months, similar to your ceramic wax, similar to the 303 glass wax, stuff like that. So pretty much to get started, I do a pre-rinse. I take the pressure washer and rinse over the car, try to get as much dirt and grime out of the car first. So I do a pre-inspection check with the pressure washer, cleaning everything off, try to get everything like waxed, well not waxed, wet. So putting water all over the car and using a pressure washer to clean up all the dirt. From there, I just take the foam canyon that I already put. I am really not that picky about it, so give or take about 2 caps of Atom shampoo and a bottle full of water. And I put it onto my pressure washer and I foam the whole car. Now from here, there's 2 options you can do. I personally like to keep the soap on and go with the 2 bucket method. Some people don't like that method. They think that you introduce more possibilities of swirl marks. So people would actually wash off the soap, then go on to the 2 bucket method. Up to you, totally. So after that, I will use the wash mitt to wash the car with the soap bucket. And then every about a panel or panel and a half, I would take it out, put it into a clean bucket, wash it off, drench all the water out off the bucket, and then put it back into the soap bucket and do it again. And then from there, you do your prep work. So this works for your first time getting your car or for your winter prep. Basically, what I do after this is use the 303 glass cleaner. And what this, not glass cleaner, 303 glass ceramic coating. I'll put the exact thing here on the visual. But first, you want to use a glass cleaner to clean your glass again, inside and out, to make sure they're clean. Even if you use soap and things like that, you would want to use glass cleaner just in case. From there, you spray the 303. The instructions to spray 1 per panel. Don't spray too much because they're really, really strong. So you spray on all your glass. So your roof glass, your hatch glass, windshield, and your four doors. Well, your 4 windows. You spray it on, then you just take a hose and just wash off the water. So you don't want to use a pressure washer here, you want to use a hose. That way it will spread out evenly over your glass, and from there you're gonna get that hydrophobicness on your windshield and on your glass. That way when it rains or snow, it won't stick to your window as much. Then you want to move on to the Meguiar ceramic wax, and here you're gonna want to spray it all over your paint while it's still wet. So we haven't dried yet, we haven't dried off the car yet. So now that we washed off the 303 from the glass, make sure it's also off your windows and all your doors. Meguiar ceramic wax, spray it all over any paint area, spray it all over your plastic trims, and spray it all over your wheels. Then you're going to take a dry towel, so you can use a waffle weave dry towel, and what you do is you're going to dry off the car with the wax. And once you dry it off with the water rinse, you can dry off the car, and then you can take another drying towel. So you dry it any way you want. Usually I dry it really carefully. Once it gets too wet, I grab another one. Drying process, there's nothing really much to talk about. You just want to use a towel so that you could spread the wax all around the car panels. From there, you want to take a second dry towel and you want to buff it out. So with wax, when you dry it off, you're going to see a bunch of wax in different weird places. You want to buff that out. And once that's buffed out, you're going to use 303 to do all your plastic trim. So take another towel or a foam applicator, put some 303 on, and every black plastic trim, put it on. So I put it on under the mirror caps, where the mirrors are, this plastic trim. I put it there. The whole plastic trims on your side panels, where the windows are, I put it all over there. The two side skirts in the bottom of both sides of the car, I put it there. Your four wheel wells, I put it down there. And then your rear diffuser and your front lip in the bottom, it's also, I put some 303. And then I move on to the interior. Interior wise, every single place that gets sun, I put 303. Anywhere that's plastic, I put 303. Rear trunk, same thing. Front trunk, not really necessary, but I did it so that it gets that matte shine. I also put 303 there. And then that's pretty much it for exterior wise. Now we move on to interior. Leather seats, depending on what you have. If you have the white leather seats, I would recommend ceramic coating it. They're about $100 a bottle. You use ceramic coating and you ceramic coat the whole white seat. That way nothing will stick. And then from there, I basically don't clean it at all. I just use some hot water, usually to clean it off. 303 wise, you want to go with everywhere. Like I said before, your steering wheels, all your plastic trims, your armrests, things like that. And if you have mats, I would also take that out and wash it. And then for your wheels, this I would use the P&L Brake Busters. I spray it on. I do this last because after you wash your car, everywhere dirty gets on the wheels anyway, so you don't want to do the opposite. So I do the wheels last. Spray some P&L, and then use a tough wheel brush to get all the rubbers washed off. And then use a wheel brush to wash off the wheel barrels and things like that. All four wheels, wash it off a pressure washer. Then you're going to use some CarPro Pearl, which is a nice car tire shine. It's water-based, so when it's raining, it's not going to go away. It's a light shine, so it's not like too crazy where you'll see, I see a bunch of people with tire shines. And man, they're so shiny, they're literally like glass on tires. And I don't like that kind of shine. If that's the tire shine you like, you go for it, but this is what I use. And I'll put it on there. You can put some tire shine on your wheel well as well, in the inside of the wheel well. That way it gives a nice sheen to it. And that's pretty much it. That's everything I do to prepare my car for the winter. Nothing too crazy. I think it's just about right on getting a car clean, and that's what I do usually before winter. And when I get my first car, the first car the first time, I wash it off with that just to get everything clean and detailed and protected. And then maintenance wash wise, for the 303, again, you don't have to reapply it unless you start seeing it graying out. Then you just apply and do the same thing what you do when you just applied it for the first time. In terms of ceramic wax, I would be cautious of that. Depending on how often you drive and how much rain you get, it can last 2 to 3 months, but if it rains a lot, it might only last you a month and a half. So wash your car, and then if you see that it's not as hydrophobic as it once was, what you do now is spray this Meguiar ceramic wax again on the panels, but this time you just wash it off. You don't have to use a towel to dry it off again, just rinse it off and then dry your car off. And it'll basically re-lubricate the ceramic wax, and that's it. That's pretty much it. So that's pretty much what I do to keep my car clean before winter, or and when I get my car for the first time. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave me in your comments how you guys wash your cars. Let me know if there's tips you have for me. I'm sure there's definitely different ways to clean the car and keep the car protected. And let me know what you guys do for your winter. I live in New York, so in the Northeast, winter can get brutal, but in the last couple of years it hasn't been that bad. But yeah, this is pretty much what I've been doing, and I'm gonna test it out, and I'll let you guys know how this has gone for my car over the winter. If you like that, please consider subscribing to this channel, so you'll be the first to know when I put up the video on how the car has held up from all this protection. And If you enjoy any videos like this, Tesla video, tech videos, also consider subscribing. But if you like this video, just give it a thumbs up. And again, let me know what you guys think of this video, your thoughts. And just give me basically your process on how you clean your car and how you protect your car as well. Thank you and have a good one.